sparkly the sand is. You can't see it probably from your angle, but it's very shimmery and sparkly, the sand. So you're kind of staying away from someone right now. You're kind of leaning to one side, kind of in avoidance mode, so to speak, avoiding certain energies. You don't want to approach someone too soon or too quickly, so that could indicate a lover, perhaps, that you're trying to, oh my gosh, I'm literally lighting my microphone on fire. Okay, I'm going to try not to go too close there. Wow, I didn't even think that was possible. Wow. Okay, I'm going to have to move this then, because that's crazy. Alright, so there's definitely some energy here where, like, you don't want to interfere, and you feel like, you know, you don't want to scare them away because they are a particular love interest of yours, and if you scare them away, it's going to be too late, you know, that sort of vibration I'm getting here. I would say it's as close to perfect as it can get, but try not to categorize yourself like, oh, I'm part of this group, or I identify this way. You know, that can hold you back from meeting a lot of people that are good for you, and like other opportunities as well, you know, because if you kind of constantly group or label yourself and others, it's like everyone's put in a box all of a sudden, and it's no fun. It's like, it destroys the mystery of, you know, people, humanity, and, so just kind of let people be, you know, no one has to be labeled, no one has to be identified, put in a box. Machine on. I'm sorry if you don't like it. I'll turn it off next time if you don't like it. A lot of you are just having such a remarkable essence about you right now. And it's like the new you, and you're still tuning into the new you. I see people working with crystals as well, like a new crystal, perhaps something you've never worked with before. For some, this is like you're starting to work a new job as well, and you didn't really expect you have to do that, but now you do, and you actually kind of like it. It's not that bad, even though it's not where you want to be in the future. It's really not that bad, honestly, so just kind of enjoy it while it lasts, because you won't be there forever. you are also coming through with abundance, so this is not a surprise. Because I'm like, why did I pick green? I'm like, oh yeah, green. So unexpected, like, check, surprise, unexpected paycheck, right? You flourishing in so many beautiful ways as well. Even though it doesn't feel like it right away, I feel like a lot of you doesn't, like, it's not hitting immediately, but it's coming. It's gonna take place. Just give it some time. Have patience with yourselves. There's something you're preparing for lunch, but maybe it, want a better plan, so maybe try meal planning, or maybe you don't have enough time to pack a lunch and you just skip a meal. Make sure you don't do that, okay? Every meal is important, all right, and part of your nutrition. So also definitely be careful and be mindful and aware of what you are consuming at this time, because it may not have short-term consequences or effects, but long-term in this case. So what are you consuming in the long term? This could indicate as well, you know, something that's not good for you, you shouldn't be eating. Make sure that that is in check as well, you know. It doesn't have to be of perfection. Just ensure that you know what you're doing, okay? And that it'll keep your body fueled and running for long years to come. There's one person in a group of friends you just want out. You don't really like them that much. They're interfering. I see interference. They're interfering with your private life. They're asking too many deep personal questions. Like, you know, that kind of energy. Maybe you're dreaming about them and it's like, it's because there's some disturbance you have, non-peace you have, or interference you have with this person. Unchecked issues, unresolved. Could be, I would really say dharma rather than karma, but could be karmic as well. This energy of like someone creeping on your page and you don't even know it, and it's just like, wow, you know, what are they watching you so closely for? Like, are you a contest or like competition in their life? Like, why are they competing against you, right? We should be working together, but anyway, they're not cooperating. Also, I feel like they're kind of a rebel in society, the rebellious of nature, but sort of an attitude problem as well. But they really liked you for some reason, so they're keeping an eye on you. It's like behind closed doors, behind the scenes. There's something with performance arts here. Performance. I see magic. I see miracles happening. Someone has a show, a play, a festival, something like that. You're at the fairgrounds and you're just having fun and eating that cotton candy, right? And you're having a great time, so just enjoy it. You know, I don't see anything wrong, really. It's just sometimes in readings I see what I need to see. It's random at certain times, but it's maybe confirmation for some people, like, oh, you know, this is legit. Like, wow, you know, I'm actually seeing someone into someone's life, you know. Also, overindulgence of sugar, be mindful, okay? This also tells me more, not everyone that appears sweet is, right? If they have a pearly white smile, you can't always trust it, okay? In fact, a lot of times that's the person you should least trust, right? If they want to seem like everything in their life is all perfect and fancy and all that stuff, it's most likely not. Honey child, okay? voice, but in this case, I feel like someone's in your life that's like putting on a smile or, you know, putting on a show for you, being a show pony, and then it's like, you know, either they don't have it like that, or there's a lot of skeletons in their closet. Stuff that they're hiding from their past, stuff they did very, very wrong, that they shouldn't have done. But overall, I see you well balanced and in harmony. I see you feeling good, just even if you don't feel good right off the bat, at least you're kind of just feeling blessed. In particular, the unexpected blessings that come through to remind you to feel happy, you know, to just keep being happy and staying that way, okay? And don't worry about tomorrow. Don't worry about the future right now, because that's tomorrow's problem. You'll meet your match, don't worry. So a lot of you were worried about a lover. Don't worry, you will meet that right person. They will come through. They will come through. You might be tired of hearing it, but this is confirmation for you if you're not tired of hearing it. Try something new, right? If you always do the same thing, get the same food, get the same color nails, try something else. It's time for a season change for you. It's time for you to change what you do. You can't expect to do the same things and have the same, not have the same results. Like what I'm trying to say is, when you keep doing the same thing, you're gonna keep getting the same results in your life. So if something didn't work, try something new. Shine a light on something new here. So this is inviting new energy, clearly. That's the message today. New blessings coming through. And that's that, guys. So let's see some final messages for you. So a lot of you living inland have to move on the coast very soon. A lot of you living on the coast have to move inland, or the coast will be closer to you, meaning maybe that water will rise and it will create a new coast. So be mindful that where you reside is never permanent residency, okay? Because if you think it is, you'll be greatly disappointed, most likely. Always have a plan ahead. So what's the final outcome message for my Poopsie Angel subscribers at home? You've been hurt before, and watch out. It's like, watch out. Don't go back to the same person who's gonna hurt you again, okay? They're gonna have an issue in their life, and they're gonna wanna reach out to you, and don't do it, okay? It's not worth your time. Don't waste. Remember the last reading, the coffee reading I did yesterday's video? Don't go back to your past. Don't replay that in your mind. Go back to that message. I feel like a lot of you are gonna resonate with that as well. So that was your one candle reading. This is typically how a 15-minute reading looks, except I usually do it in a candle bowl. Hey, if you request for me to do it on paper, you know, on sand for your booking, I can do it in ASMR. You know, I can do it. Absolutely, I can do anything, most things, actually, that you request. So that was your reading. Thank you, love and light, God bless. And please sign up for my newsletter on TonyBomboni.com, links below, for 20% off for life, for all my services, unlimited use.